Hare Krishna. Education is meant to inform and transform our imagination. Suppose a young person has just learned driving and he is driving a car at a super high speed. And some people love to be called as speed demons. Zoom! They shoot past, and when everybody else looks around, when they feel the sensation of speed, they get a kick out of it. And they may imagine, people will look at me with such amazement and admiration. And that imagination fuels them. But if they do a proper driving education course, car driving learning course, and at that time they are educated about what the consequences of rash driving can be, they might veer off course because the road is slippery, and they may kill themselves. They may lifelong suffer a handicap or a deformation or a disfigurement, or they may hit another car where there might be a small child who gets crushed to death. When they hear about these consequences, then they become sober. Now, this education, it informs and transforms their imagination. Their imagination was going off primarily in the direction of why I should drive fast. But now, their imagination goes in the direction of why I should not drive too fast. And then, that education becomes successful. Because once the person's imagination becomes an aid to caution, then that person will not succumb to the temptation again. Similarly, in our spiritual life, we often acquire a lot of spiritual knowledge. What is the purpose of this knowledge? This education is actually meant to inform and transform our imagination. So, we often fantasize. If we engage in sensual pleasures, there will be so much enjoyment available. Oh, I can enjoy this, I can enjoy that. This will be so wonderful. But if we study the Bhagavad Gita and understand the true nature of pleasure, then, for example, 18.37-38, Krishna talks about the nature of material pleasure and the nature of spiritual pleasure. Material pleasure, he says, is that which tastes like nectar in the beginning, but like poison in the end. Vishayendriya sanyoga dyatadagre amritopamam pariname vishamiva tatsukham rajasamsmritam. So he says that sensual pleasure, if our mind is only imagining about the initial nectar, it will impel us towards that. But if we imagine about the subsequent poison, then we will become cautious. If a person simply thinks about the high that comes from drinking, they'll feel impelled to drink. But if that person thinks about the nasty hangover that comes after drinking, the loss of money, sometimes the loss of face, the loss of health, and sometimes drunken driving which can lead to death, when the person contemplates that and when we let the mind imagine that, then immediately we will be checked. So, our imagination normally fuels our sensuality. But we can channel our imagination so that it checks our sensuality. And rather than simply imagining negative consequences, we can also channel our imagination positively by contemplating the wonderful results of spiritual discipline. Krishna says in 18.37 that Yattadagre vishamiva pariname amritopamam tatsukham sattvikam proktam atmabuddhi prasadajam. That although spiritual practices taste like poison in the beginning, they will taste like nectar in the end. When we observe advanced devotees relishing the nectar of Krishna bhakti, from them we can get the inspiration to press on. We can fuel our imagination with the eventual spiritual ecstasy that awaits us, and thus we will be able to penetrate through the initial spiritual austerity. So when our imagination is just thus informed about the eventual consequences, and thus it is transformed from imagining about the joys of sensuality to the joys of spirituality, then our imagination becomes a friend and our education attains completion, bringing about transformation in our life and elevating us towards spiritual liberation. Thank you. Hare Krishna.